Hi viewers, this is Khalid Mahmood with the video Geographic Information System, and in this video you will learn about Geographic Information System layer or a feature class, point, polyline, polygon. You will know about spatial or geographic data and its types as well. You will know learn about attribute, georeferencing, geocoding, geographic coordinate system, degrees, minutes, seconds, and decimal degrees. So what is spatial or geographic data? Data having location information on the Earth's surface is known as spatial or geographic data. Now let's come to the definition of GIS. A GIS is a system to handle such spatial or geographic data. Layer or a feature class. A feature class is a collection of geographic features that share the same geometry types, such as point, polyline, or polygon, and the same attribute fields for a common area, street, well points, parcels, soil types, and census tracts are examples of feature classes. Suppose this is our planet Earth, and if you want to survey it or digitize, you can digitize in three type of layers: point, polyline, and polygon or area. Here is an example of feature classes. So what are the spatial data types? Vector data and raster data. So let's have a look on vector data and raster data as a point, line, and polygon. Let's come to the definition of vector data. Actually, vector is a data structure used to store spatial data, which we have defined before as point, polyline, and polygon. Raster data is made up of pixels or cells, and each pixel has an associated value. For example, satellite images. What is an attribute? So before, we know that a spatial data has a location. So spatial data has location plus other information as well. So the other information except that location, which represents a feature, that is known as attribute. For example, a person's identity card number, his age, his her gender, and contact number, all of examples of attributes. What is a geographic coordinate system? So it's basically to identify the exact locations on the surface of the Earth. A geographic coordinate system is used in this case, normally, and x and y axis are used in mathematical systems, but in geography, these axes are referred as latitude and longitude. Latitude is a horizontal lines that runs east to west, and longitudes are vertical lines that run north to south. So here is an example of latitude and longitude. As you know that latitude lines range between minus 90 and plus 90 degrees, and these latitude lines are imaginary lines on the Earth surface, and they run east and west parallel to the equator around the globe, and you know that equator is 0 degree. Remember latitude by thinking of a ladder. Sounds similar. The ladder has rungs which you climb to go up and down, similar to the lines of latitude which go up and down. So do remember, once a latitude comes into your mind, do remember the ladder. There is an example of latitude with the ladder. Longitude coordinates are between minus 180 and plus 180 degree. Longitude lines run from pole to pole, yani north to south, all the way around the globe and tell you your distance east or west from the prime meridian. The prime meridian longitude 0 and is a reference line from which longitude east and west are measured. It passes through the Greenwich, England. Here is an example of longitude with the poles. Georeferencing and geocoding. Georeferencing and geocoding are different but similar processes, since both involving in the fitting of the data to the appropriate coordinates, means location, to the real world. Georeferencing is the process of assigning coordinates to vectors or rasters so they can be oriented accurately on a model of the Earth's surface. The data used in geocoding and addresses and location descriptors, city, country, etc. Each of these locations is given the exact coordinates of reference for that location on the surface of the Earth. So, what are degree, minute, seconds and decimal degrees? We can find any location on the Earth using latitude and longitude coordinates, and we measure those coordinates with decimal degrees or degrees, minutes and seconds. Let's know the difference between them. One way to write spherical coordinates, latitude and longitude, is using degree, minutes, seconds. Minutes and seconds range from 0 to 60. For example, the geographic coordinate system in degree, minutes, seconds for New York City is this one. And here is an example of with the map. But you can also express geographic coordinates in decimal degrees as well. It's just another way to present that same location in a different format. For example, here is New York City in decimal degrees with these values. So, hope you have enjoyed the video. So, like and subscribe our channel for more relevant videos. Thank you very much.